Welcome back. Today, we're going to take a quick peek at the new Garden Party series requests that have been available on the weekends recently. Garden Party is a new event that's part of the Journey of Dreams series. This one is very unique in that it builds up server-wide progress. When the region reaches Tier 1, everyone will be able to claim the Garden Party Dream Sticker. According to the dates on Global, we have until January 3rd, 2022 to complete them, but they only show up every Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. The quests themselves are very simple and quick to complete. It's definitely worth doing, not only to push along your region progress, but also for the unique happiness token currency that will unlock rewards in the token shop. So, how do you start it? On days that the event is active, there will be special quests named Garden Party Special Event. There's an islander who keeps staring at you. Head over to Komodo and you'll be able to speak with Pabudura. He invites you to be a part of the festivities by participating in mini-games offered by the many invited guests in Komodo. After accepting the task, you now have 8 quests to choose from, scattered all around the island. You will only need to complete 6 to receive the final reward. Let's now go over each one. You can find Hetty near the center of the bustling city to complete the Saintess's Garden Party plan. She is having some problems with the shooting game and needs help. You will be given a target to shoot at, use the toy gun to be able to target, and win the game for her. Brandis is located on the top left side of the island. He gives the quest, Special Training of the Child of Stars. He asks if you'd like to train, and explains about allowing you to finish up the magical array for a grand prize. There's a pattern that will appear on the screen. Simply click down and follow the route by the numbers given. Someone, such as a Windrake, will appear and scold Brandis. I've had guildies tell me that they've even seen a pouring spawn. Pay close attention to the magical array pattern, as it's also not always the same every time. Nada is located in the top left of the island. She will offer the quest 100% Clever, which happens to be a special quiz game. She asks simple little questions for rewards. The most common one I've seen is, what color is crab? Which is definitely red. Answer the question to receive your reward. The divination guru, Victor N. Vivi, can be found in the middle of town. It turns out Victor is Noen V's nephew and is offering divinations through the quest, The Kitty's Diviner. You will have a series of questions that you can answer however you'd like, and Victor will respond with his thoughts on your choices. Near the bottom left of the town is Gun, who offers the quest Hidden Gift. It seems that Gun has lost track of Uruk and would like him back. Find Uruk, who will shamelessly bribe you with a party gift, only so you don't give away his location to Gun. Open the gift box to complete the quest. Everyone's favorite pal, Holgrahen, also happens to be at the party. On the left side of the island, you can find him with the quest, The Komodo of My Heart. He wants to participate in a photo competition for a prize. The quest now encourages you to also take a photo. Lovechan will show up loving your photo and would love to have it in exchange for happiness tokens and a happiness bean. Around the center of town, you can find a snowman named Samantha to begin the troublemaking snowman quest. Samantha would like you to pick the box that's holding a special Komodo dessert, but we aren't fooled. And now you shake down Samantha to reveal that they were holding it the whole time. On the right side of the island is the quest, Kitten Smitten. Speak with Abby Mooser to start. It seems Abby and Carrie travel very often, and Abby is super protective of Carrie. Abby then requests that you play the finger guessing game with Carrie to see if she will meow. The game is simply rock, paper, scissors. Choose an option, and Abby is usually disappointed at the lack of meows. Once you complete 6 quests for the day, the game will retrieve your happiness beans and you can once again speak to Pabudura, who is waving at you. Don't forget this crucial part, as you'll be given the final 60 happiness tokens and the Komodo Amusement Park gift box. The gift box will give a Pouring Growth Panacea, Meteoric Chain, Intensive Job Potion, and Time Invitation Tickets, and a special chance for Frere Coins. As you can see, most of the quests are very simple, and we've actually seen similar minigames before, particularly in the Wasteland and Blooming Land dailies. They are rather fun in that some have a variety of outcomes or slight variances while doing them. I'm not sure if there would be a rotation of quests in the future, But if there's any changes, I'm sure the quests available would be just as simple in design. Now, with all that hard work out of the way, what can we use those happiness tokens for? You can open the token exchange shop by clicking on Journey of Dreams in the New Event tab and select the token exchange on the left-hand side of the UI, which is right below Garden Party. Click the Go Now button and it will open up the full selection. There are runes, red feast tickets, and so much more. You only receive 120 tokens a day for 3 days, so that is 360 a week. Most items have purchase limits as well, so remember to choose wisely. Definitely remember to check out Garden Party every weekend so you don't miss out on everything that it has to offer. Thanks again for joining me today. I'm still working on the next Cloudsea video, but please send me some luck and energy on unlocking the new gifts. This, unlike RBNG, has still been so bad. Hope to see you again next time. Till then, take care of yourselves. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the guide, please remember to like and subscribe. Do you have any questions? Feel free to leave a comment. And if you'd like to check out my other content, I go live on Twitch 3 times a week. I'd love to meet you. Happy gaming.